Let's learn about the structure of bone. Let's begin with the structure of a long bone. Long bones include a proximal epiphysis and metaphysis. The long shaft of the bone is called the diaphysis. There is also a distal metaphysis and epiphysis. The epiphysis and metaphysis are separated by the epiphyseal plate. The matrix of bone contains collagen, hydroxyapatite, glycosaminoglycans, proteoglycans, glycoproteins, along with calcium carbonate, sodium, magnesium, potassium, sulfate, fluoride, and hydroxide ions. The inside of long bones contains two types of bone, spongy and compact bone. Spongy bone contains trabeculae that help to give it its strength while reducing the overall weight of the bone. The trabeculae develop along the lines of stress. The matrix of spongy bone is arranged in lamellae with few osteons. Compact bone is found in the margins of long bones. Compact bone is arranged in structural units called osteons or haversian systems. Each osteon contains concentric rings called lamellae arranged around a central canal. Small canaliculi create an interconnected network. Central canals are connected to each other via transverse or diagonal perforating or Volksmann's canals. The outer surface of bone contains a fibrous covering called the periosteum that contains blood vessels, nerves, and lymphatics. The medullary cavity is lined with the endosteum and contains marrow. Red bone marrow is found in children and produces blood cells. In adults, most of the red marrow has been converted to yellow marrow. Some bones, including the bones of the skull, vertebrae, sternum, ribs, coxal bones, and proximal portions of the humerus and femur, still contain red marrow. Blood vessels and nerves enter bone through nutrient foramen, which are small holes in the diaphysis. They carry important nutrients for development and maintenance of bone. Types of bone cells include osteocytes, osteoblasts, osteogenic cells, and osteoclasts. Osteogenic cells are stem cells that can multiply and develop into other bone cells. Osteoblasts are bone-forming cells that do not multiply. New osteoblasts come from osteogenic cells. Trapped osteoblasts become osteocytes. Depending on their location, osteocytes can form or resorb bone and contribute to remodeling of bone according to applied forces. Osteocytes contain small processes that reach into canaliculi to connect with other osteocytes. Osteoclasts are large cells that develop from monocytes and macrophages. Their function is to resorb bone. I hope you have learned something about the structure of bone, and see you next time.